Hi students, now we'll be doing another topic from linear algebra, kernel and range. So, how do we define a kernel and range? If we take a mapping L from a vector space V to W, then if this is a linear transformation, what is the kernel then? Kernel of L is nothing but the set of all such vectors V such that when L is applied on V, it maps it to the zero of vector space W. Or we can say that kernel of L is the set of all vectors V such that LV is equal to zero of W. And what is range? Range is nothing but the set of all images LV. Coming to the dimension theorem, let's say we have a linear transformation L from a vector space V to W, and we have the kernel L and range L, then the dimension theorem states that dimension of the kernel L plus dimension of the range L, if it is added, it gives us the dimension of the vector space V. Let's take an example. What if we are given a linear transformation L from R3 to R3, and it is such that L, when applied on a vector x1, x2, x3 of R3, it gives us 1, minus 1, 1, 2, 1, minus 1, 1, 2, minus 2, x1, x2, x3. Right hand side, of course, is the image. Now, if we want to find that a particular vector 0, 3, minus 3 here belongs to the kernel or not, how will we do that? We will check whether a vector belongs to the kernel and a vector belongs to the range or not. We will also check and verify the dimension theorem. So to start with, let's take the vector 0, 3, minus 3. Now, we will, as we know that your kernel L is nothing but the set of all vectors V such that L of V is equal to 0. So we will equate L of x1, x2, x3 equal to 0. If you simplify, right hand side is equal to x1 minus x2 plus x3, 2x1 plus x2 minus x3, x1 plus 2x2 minus 2x3. So if we substitute the point 0, 3 minus 3 in our right hand side and it becomes 0, 0, 0, we will confirm that the point belongs to the kernel, otherwise it does not. In our case, we get 0, 0, 0, so the point belongs to the kernel. Let's take another point, 1, 2, minus 2. When we substitute it in our equation 1, we see that we get x1 as minus 3, x2 as 6, x3 as 9, which is not 0, 0, 0. Which means that L of V has not given us 0 of R3. So it does not belong to the kernel of L. To check if 3 minus 2 minus 5 belongs to the range of L or not, what we'll do, we will solve the system, and the right hand side of our equations will have the point 3 minus 2 minus 5. As we know, range of L is nothing but the set of all images. So if we can find x1, x2, x3, that is, the system is solvable, then we say it belongs to the range. So let's write it as an augmented matrix. So we have formed an augmented matrix and we do row echelon form. We bring it to that form. We will see that such a system is solvable. And it has infinite solutions. So 3 minus 2 minus 5 belongs to the range L. Which means that this is one of the points in our range. What if we want to check 5, 9, 7 belongs to the range or not? We will now take our right hand side as 5, 9, 7 in the system of equations. And again, we form the augmented matrix. We see that when we reduce it to the row echelon form, the system is not solvable. which means that 597 does not belong to the range of L. If we want to verify the dimension theorem, we will first find the kernel of L. For that, we know that we will equate our LV to 0. LV is nothing but x1 minus x2 plus x3, 2x1 plus x2 minus x3, and x1 plus 2x2 minus 2x3. We equate it to 0, 0, 0. And we solve this homogeneous system. So, we see that in this case, if we take our x3, which is the independent variable to be k, we see x1, x2, x3 on solving, they come out to be 0, k, k. We write it as a vector. And if we take out the k, we will get k 0, 1, 1. So, what will be kernel? Kernel will be set of all such vectors. The basis of the kernel is 0, 1, 1. And as there is just one element in the basis, the dimension of the basis is 1. Now, to find the range L, we see that the right hand side is 1, minus 1, 1. 2, 1, minus 1, 1, 2, minus 2. And this is made up of three vectors, 1, 2, 1, minus 1, 1, 2, 1, minus 1, 2. So we will have to check which out of the three vectors are linearly independent. Only those vectors will be a part of the basis. So for that, we will arrange them in the matrix and we reduce it to the form given here in the row echelon form. We see that the first two columns have a pivot. So they are the vectors which are linearly independent. And hence, the vectors corresponding to these two vectors, namely 1, 2, 1 and minus 1, 1, 2, they are a part of the basis for the span of range L. So, our basis of range L will be these two vectors, 1, 2, 1, minus 1, 1, 2. Here, because we have two vectors in the basis, the dimension of the range L is 2. From the dimension theorem, if we write the dimensions of kernel, which is 1, and add the dimension of range, which is 2, we get 3. 3 is the dimension of R3. So, the dimension theorem is proved. Let's take another example, and here we are given a mapping from R2 to R3. So, for this linear transformation, which gives the rule as L of x1, x2 is x1, x1 plus x2 and x2, we'll first find the kernel L, which means we have to equate L x1, x2 to 0, 0, 0, where this 0, 0, 0 is the 0 of R3. We are finding all those V such that LV is equal to 0. And we'll solve and find the values of x1, x2. We see on solving we get x1, x2 is 0, 0, which means the kernel has only a 0 vector. And hence, the dimension of kernel will be 0. Coming to the range of L. Now here, we see that the image x1, x1 plus x2 and x2 is made up of x1, 1, 1, 0 and plus x2, 0, 1, 1. So, there are two vectors. We will now find whether these two vectors are linearly independent or not. Range of L has these two vectors. They both are the images. So, if we write them in an augmented matrix and we arrange them in a matrix and do the row echelon form, we'll find both the vectors are linearly independent, which means that the basis has these two vectors, 1, 1, 0 and 0, 1, 1. These are the original vectors corresponding to the two vectors in the row echelon form. Hence, the dimension of range L is 2 as there are two vectors. So, we see that the dimension theorem is satisfied. The dimension of kernel is 0, the dimension of range is 2. If we add, we get 2, which is the dimension of R2. In the next example, we are given a linear transformation from P2 to P3. And the rule is that L changes the polynomials of degree less than or equal to 2 into Cx cube plus Bx square plus Ax. So here we have to find the kernel L, and we will, for that we will equate L Ax square plus Bx plus C, where this is a polynomial from P2. As we know, L of this polynomial is equal to Cx cube plus Bx square plus Ax. We'll equate it to 0. And we see that this is only possible if A, B, C is 0. Hence, the kernel of L is equal to 0. It has only the 0 vector. So, the dimension of kernel will be 0. For the range, now we see that the right hand side, the polynomial Cx cube plus Bx square plus Ax is written as x cube C0, 0, x square 0, B0 plus x 0, 0, A. So if we pull out C, B and A, we see that our image is formed by the three vectors 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0 and 0, 0, 1. We know that these are the unit vectors, the identity, these are I, J and K, so they form a basis. And the dimension of range L is 3. So, from the dimension theorem, 0, the range of the dimension of kernel, plus 3, the dimension of range, that equals to 3, which is dimension of P2. The dimension of a polynomial Pn is always n plus 1. Now, when is a linear transformation 1-to-1 and onto? Let's see. Given a linear transformation L from V to W, it is said to be 1-to-1 whenever the dimension of the kernel L is 0. Or we can say that kernel of L has only a 0 vector of V. And it is onto if and only if the dimension of the range L is equal to dimension of W. We'll do a few examples. If L is a linear transformation from R3 to R3, which is given by L x, y, z is 2x, x plus y plus z minus y, we have to check whether it is 1-to-1 and onto or not. So, to first find the kernel L, we will equate L of x, y, z to 0, as L of x, y, z is 2x, x plus y plus z minus y. We equate it to 0. We solve. We see x, y and z are all 0. So the kernel has only the 0 element of R3. Hence, the dimension of kernel is 0. So it is 1-to-1. For the range, we have the image as 2x, x plus y plus z minus y, which we can write as x 2-1-0 plus y 0-1-1 plus z 0-1-0. So if we take the vectors 2-1-0, 0-1-1 and 0-1-0 and check whether they are linearly independent or not, for that we'll put them in columns and do the row echelon form. We see that each column has a pivot, so S, this subset, is linearly independent, and the basis of the range L will be formed by the vectors 2-1-0, 0-1-1, 0-1-0. These are the vectors which correspond to our final matrix 1-0-0, 0-1-0 and 0-1-1. So the dimension of the range L is 3, which is dimension of R3. Therefore, L is onto. In the next example, we have a linear transformation L from P2 to P2. And it is given by L of Ax square plus Bx plus C is equal to A plus Bx square plus B plus Cx plus A plus C. For 1-to-1, we will equate L of x square plus Bx plus C is equal to 0. This will give us that all A, B and C are 0 on solving, which means that the kernel of L has only the 0 vector. which means L is 1 to 1 because the dimension of the kernel L is 0. Now for onto, we have to see the image. So the image is a plus bx square plus b plus cx plus a plus c, which we can write as a x square plus 1 plus b x square plus x plus c x plus 1. S is nothing but the subset of x square plus 1, x square plus x and x plus 1. We have to check whether S is linearly independent or not. So if we put the coefficients of x square, x and the constant term in columns and solve and reduce it to the row echelon form, we see that the three columns have a pivot, and if we want to see the rank, we see rank is 3 and that is equal to number of vectors. So S is linearly independent. And the basis of the range L is nothing but 101, 110 and 011. It is formed by these three vectors. Dimension of the range will be 3. So L is onto because this condition is satisfied. In the third example, we have L is P2 to M22. It is given by L of AX square plus BX plus C is A plus C0, B minus C minus 3A. So for 1 to 1, when we equate the image to 0, 0, we get A, B, C all to be 0. Again, dimension of the kernel will be 0, so L is 1 to 1. Dimension of the range, we need not find by solving the right hand side or the image, because from the dimension theorem we know that dimension of kernel plus dimension of range is equal to dimension of our vector space V. So we know what is our vector space V, that is P2, and we know what is the dimension of P2, it is 3. So from 3, if we subtract the dimension of kernel, which is 0, we get the dimension of range, which is 3. But this is not equal to the dimension of M22, which is equal to 4. So L is not onto. Thank you.